Mr. Chair, distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to thank the Westminster Foundation for Democracy for inviting Club de Madrid to take part in this important gathering to discuss such a crucial issue facing the humanity. However, before I start, I'd like to share a bit of information about Club de Madrid, our general objectives, and what it brings us here today. Club de Madrid, of which I am a member and vice president, is the world's largest forum of former head of state and government in democratic nations. It is dedicated to strengthening democratic values and leadership. It counts on the accumulated governance experience of more than 115 members from over 70 countries. This unique alliance stimulates dialogue, builds bridges, and engages in advocacy efforts to strengthen democratic public policies and effective leadership through recommendations that tackle challenges such as inclusion, democratic governance, sustainable development, and peace at the national and multilateral level. Club de Madrid is privileged to count on with so many political leaders who have played important roles in climate negotiations and have taken bold action on climate policies during their terms in office. Personally, I served as one of the special envoys of the UN Secretary General of Climate Change, together with Prime Minister Gro Harlem Brundtland of Norway and President Ricardo Lagos of Chile at the time of COP13 in Bali, Indonesia. I also served as the UN Secretary General Special Envoy for Disaster Risk Reduction on Water at the time of Third United Nations World Conference on Disaster Risk Reduction in 2015. As you may know, 80% of climate change impacts are channeled through water. When I served as chair of the OECD Ministerial Council meeting in Paris, I was able to garner the unanimous support of the minister delegates to pass a resolution on green growth in June 2009. I strongly believe that unless we change the paradigm of growth from the quantitative to qualitative, that is green growth, we will not be able to solve the problem of climate change. Therefore, I was instrumental in founding GGGI, Global Green Growth Institute, of which I served as founding chair of the board of directors. GGGI is transformed into an international organization at Rio Plus 20 in 2012. Even today, I serve as water and climate leader at the World Meteorological Organization. I am particularly pleased to inform you that from this year, I will be taking part in a new Club de Madrid initiative on climate change at this critical juncture in human history. Ladies and gentlemen, climate change is one of the greatest challenges for democracy. However, democracies have not sufficiently managed to act beyond the confines of the national borders. The short-term focus of some democratic decision-making has been an additional weakness. Our continued reliance on fossil fuels makes the global economy and energy security vulnerable to geopolitical shocks and crises. Now is the time to accelerate the energy transition to a renewable energy for the future. For this reason, the Club de Madrid has developed a new initiative called Leadership for Net Zero, how to achieve net zero through democratic principles and practices. I am to chair this new commission. We know that there is much to do to achieve net zero, a climate neutral world. It will require the adoption of far-ranging policies with a long-term perspective that will have to radically change people's way of lives, from production systems and consumption patterns to land use, food, transport, housing, and others. The transformation must be accompanied by everyone in the society, citizens, governments, media, business leaders, and many others. It is concerning that even climate change action supporters may turn their back on some of the policy measures required to achieve net zero once the economic and social consequences, such as price hikes for energy and everyday commodities, become tangible and begins to affect their daily lives. Therefore, democratic leadership has to present a vision that net zero can bring higher economic growth and better quality jobs in the long run, if social consensus to overcome short-term difficulties is to be mobilized. For this reason, government leaders who are committed to achieving net zero, as well as civil society leaders, must tread carefully in order to keep public support for climate actions. They must learn to make use of all the existing instruments of democratic systems and think of new ones to listen to citizen preferences and help shape them too. This calls for a strong and innovative decision-making leadership. Our aim with this initiative is to help current government, civil society, and business leaders provide them with a set of recommendations that will identify the kind of leadership needed to achieve net zero. We plan to do this with the support of our members and knowledge of our networks of experts and practitioners. We hope to convene a series of policy discussions led by a core group of Club Madrid members, expert advisors, and knowledge partners to put forward a concrete set of recommendations for the use of current political, civil society, and business leaders on how to lead the adoption of ambitious climate policy with a citizen-responsive approach rooted in democratic principles with all regional perspectives in the account. Now is time to turn all our knowledge and ambition into action, and Club de Madrid members will turn our backs to this reality. We very much look forward to count on you as partners and colleagues on this path as we look ahead. Let us grasp the opportunities of working together under an active, open, and networked multilateralism. We will all have a crucial role to play in protecting the people and our planet. You can be in contact with us directly via the Secretariat of Club de Madrid, and we will be happy to have you on board. I wish you a fruitful session and every success in the important works to ahead. Thank you for your attention.